Hello, everyone. I'm going to demonstrate the Image Downloader extension. I already downloaded it and pinned it to the toolbar. There are two ways to use the extension. You can open it as a pop-up, or you can right-click the icon and choose Open Side Panel to open it as a side panel. As you can see, in the side panel are all the images that are available in the site. You can choose which images to download by clicking them and then clicking the Download selected icon. Another option is to download all the images by clicking the Download All icon. The extension gives you the option to filter the images. There are four filters: size, type, layout, and URL. But before I will demonstrate that, let us go to display and change the width of the images in the side panel to 40%. Now, we can see much more of the images. Okay, let's go back to filters. The first filter is CZ. You can set the minimum width, minimum height, maximum height, and maximum width. For example, I set the width between 50 and 500 pixels. You can quickly choose an image size using the buttons, press them, and the extension will automatically configure the image filter for small, medium, large, and all images. Another options are to filter images by type: JPEG, PNG, GIF, and so on, or by layout: all, wide, square, and tall. You can also choose your own specific ratio. For example, I can choose width to height ratio that is bigger than 1.2. You can see that all the photos displayed have larger than 1.2 ratio. Anytime I want for a setting to persist, I can click on the floppy disk icon to save the setting in that submenu. If I exit the extension and go back, you can see the ratio setting is still there. One more filter that is available is the URL filter. You can include or exclude URLs. You are not limited to a single URL. You can use multiple URLs by separating them with a semicolon. There are some other options that are available. In the Save submenu, you can choose to save file in a folder generated by the extension. Click next to the empty box to save it in the Download folder. Put text in the box for a custom folder name. By default, the name of the files is generated automatically by the extension. You can give the files a name. If I set the name to cat, all file names will start with cat: cat1, cat2, cat3. Lastly, we can go to the display. Here in the display, we can set language. If at any point you need some help, press the icon on the corner and choose the user guide or the contact US link.